Hey, what's up, cats and kittens, and shout out to all my cerebralites. It's me, the Cerebral Diva, back with another episode of You Say What. And for those of you who are new to my channel, You Say What is your opportunity to chime in, to be a part of the discussion, to add your two cents in this community of cerebralites, which I like to call the Brain Trust. So today we're going to talk about Katy Perry. And we're going to talk about the rap group Migos. So Katy Perry had a recent appearance on Saturday Night Live where she performed two songs, her current single, which is Bon Appetit, which features Migos, and then she has a second song, which is sort of a quasi-gay voguing anthem, which is called Swish Swish, and that features Nicki Minaj. So Katy's on Saturday Night Live, and she's doing her thing, and she's, you know, laying across the table, and there's all sorts of fruit and other edibles, you know, framing her on this table. And you see the rap group of Migos, and you see two female dancers, and flanking the two female dancers, you see drag queens. So I'm like, okay, that's different. And prior to that, she had also did a first song, which was Swish Swish, which was primarily all drag queens. So as I'm watching the song, I'm thinking to myself, okay, that's really progressive. You know, seeing the juxtaposition of hip-hop, which is, as much as people may not want to admit it, which is extremely homophobic and hyper-masculine, juxtaposed against, you know, drag queens and voguing, I'm like, this is different. I mean, and maybe it can be super progressive, or maybe it can go completely wrong. And so now we're hearing reports that Migos were completely uncomfortable, and I guess feeling slightly ambushed by the fact that they had to appear with drag queens and had some stipulations in terms of arrangements, how they were placed to make sure that there was a buffer between them and the drag queens. Now, even though I'm a huge proponent, a huge advocate for all things LGBT, I can understand the Migos and why they did what they did. I think to a large degree, if we're going to point the finger, we also have to point the finger at Katy Perry's team. Katy Perry's team should have had the presence of mind to say, this might not be a good mix. Because it may be good for the Katy Perry brand, but not so much for the Migos brand. And so to me, it seems like she was putting her brand above their brand. Let's face it, hip-hop is not one that's completely embraced homosexuality. So to put them in a position where you could affect their brand long-term, I don't think was fair to Migos. Now, we have to understand that hip-hop is how they eat. And albeit homophobic, at the end of the day, this is what's paying their bills. So in 2017, if they were to appear, let's say, just be friendly, amiable, they take a picture with one of the drag queens just because they're that progressive and that comfortable, we know that's going to turn into memes, that's going to go viral, people are going to be saying, oh, they're gay, oh, look at the, you know, they're going to be using all sorts of anti-gay slurs, you know, so I can understand why Migos would say, look, if I'm going to do this or if we're going to do this, we have to make sure that we're protecting our brand. And that's essentially what they were doing. And granted, it's homophobic to a large degree, but it's business. It's business. Now, if you come to me and you say in their personal lives that Migos are, you know, don't want to be affiliated, I'm sure that, you know, if you were, it's hard to not work in the entertainment industry and not come across, you know, people who are of the LGBT variety, people who are stylists, people who are makeup artists, people who are in hair, people who are set designers. You know, you're going to encounter people of the LGBT variety, and I'm sure Migos is no exception to that. But there's a difference between personal and professional. In the professional hip-hop arena, they haven't progressed to the point that they're able to be inclusive in that way. And so I think that to judge Migos for protecting their brand is not a fair thing to do. That's just me. Now, I don't agree with the logic. I don't agree with the pathology. But I do agree that at the end of the day, if this is how they eat, they have a right to make sure that that's protected. So even when you look at like the Billboard Awards with Lil Uzi Vert, I think that's his name, the social media is going crazy because he's worn two blouses. He's a male artist who seems to have a penchant for female clothing, or at least their tops, their blouses, if you will. And that makes people very uncomfortable. And I think that until hip hop progresses, until we as a society progress, we can't necessarily sort of look down our noses at Migos for wanting to make sure that they're preserving the longevity of their careers in a society that is to a large degree very homophobic and very non-inclusive. So that's my opinion, you guys. This is You Say What. So I want to hear your two cents. I want you to chime in. I want you to be a part of the discussion. So make sure you comment below. Make sure you follow me across all social media platforms, Facebook, Instagram, Snapchat, and Twitter. Also, as always in closing, remember to live better, love harder, and think smarter. It's me, the Cerebral Diva, and I will talk to you guys again soon.